Micro drives are tiny 1-inch mechanical hard drives, and they come in retro PC friendly sizes from a couple of hundred megabytes to maybe 8 gigabytes or so. These micro drives are fully compatible with the IDE interface, and you can get such an adapter. So you insert the drive here and then you take this and plug it into the IDE interface. Power supply goes here, and now you have a IDE hard drive. In this video, we will find out if they're useful for retro PC gaming. The capacities are quite useful, but what about performance? And are you better off using a standard compact flash card instead? The micro drive got detected without any issues. I partitioned and formatted it and then copied the Windows 98 installation files across, but performance is very limited. These hard drives have a rotational speed of only 3600 RPM. On the video, you can see the Windows 98 installation in real time comparing the micro drive with the compact flash card, and the compact flash card is much, much faster. We have some benchmarks here on the screen. With a USB 3 compact flash adapter, we're getting around 7 megabytes per second, and running the ATTO disk benchmark on the retro PC, around 3 to 4.5 megabytes per second. This is the test PC we're using today, a Pentium 4 running at 2.8 gigahertz with 256 megabytes of video memory using a chipset from SIS. After Windows 98 is installed, and then I'm installing chipset drivers and we are testing a few games, and yeah, you can definitely tell that the micro drive is significantly slower compared to the compact flash card. So for Windows 98, I would probably not recommend such a micro drive. The performance is just too slow. But what about DOS? The capacities seem to be perfect, and a lot of these older BIOSes on old retro PCs, they have issues with large drives. So having hard drives of around 4 gigabytes, yeah, seems to be perfect. But it didn't take too long, and we can see there's something else going on with these micro drives. Here we have Doom, and every now and then the game will simply pause, and you can see the hard drive activity icon in the bottom right corner of the screen. And what is happening here is these micro drives come from portable music devices, and they have a very aggressive power management setting. They will go from full performance to idle within 2 seconds or something like that. So these pauses are the hard drive basically waking up from idle. And then, yeah, it takes, there's a small delay for them to be fully accessible. And that's what we're seeing here in Doom. So guys, it didn't take me too long to come to a conclusion with these micro drives. For Windows 98, the performance is just too slow. And even for DOS, if you're playing games where it will on a regular basis access the hard drive, you will see skips and pauses because the micro drives have a very aggressive power management going on. So they are constantly being woken up from idle into full performance mode. So that leaves us with older, with even older DOS games where the regular streaming is not so much happening, maybe old text adventures and games that fully fit into the memory. Here a micro drive definitely has its uses. So it boils down to pricing and availability. Compact flash cards are also everywhere. You get all sorts of brands. Used models, you get brand new ones, and the performance on these are much, much better. They do not have these issues with the power management. So guys, there you have it. This was a short and sweet video. These micro drives have very limited uses with retro gaming PCs. The bottom line is for very low prices, you can get compact flash cards, which clearly outperform these micro drives. So it means if you're getting a really good price, or you're getting these for free maybe, then yeah, have a go. See if your DOS games work well with these. Windows 98, I don't see you having much fun with these drives. And even under DOS, games that stream data off the hard drive, you will see skips and pauses. So I think in most situations, you're simply better off buying a compact flash card. And that's it for this video, guys. Let me know what you think. I have some links for you in the description if you're interested in buying some compact flash cards. And yeah, that's really it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so and give it a like, leave a comment, and let me know if you've used these micro drives in your retro gaming PC before. And yeah, what do you think about these? Thank you for watching. And I shall see you soon with another one.